Cynthia into listen, and then we're gonna announce Eddie.
Cynthia into what?
Cynthia, okay. Change on me into Eddie. Listen.
Let me go
listen.
And,
the listen song.
He doesn't have.
Oh, then don't worry about them. Just play Cynthia, and then.
We haven't given that up to
I think I have it.
He has it. He played the last time we went to his house, but it's fine.
Just the Cynthia is fine because once he starts talking, you gotta give him a little
change
shot.
Change on me, beat them in. It's a little bit slower
are
than
we
the
on?
Listen.
Are we on?
I just gotta click on. Hold on.
Alright. Yeah, just play change on me for now, and then we'll bring Eddie in. That's fine. Go ahead and click on. Let's get him back popping.
What's my phone? Cynthia, of course, all the freestyle heads, we do know the song Change On Me. She's from Wagner Projects around the way. I'm from Jefferson Projects. And we all pretty much come from the Spanish. I can't give you shout outs because I'm not really reading who's on. But we're going to keep this moving. And we're not trying to get shut down right now. So we're just having a good time. Thursday. Listen, we're giving you a treat. This is actually a record that we released, but we're going to revisit. It's called I Can't Change Your Mind. Lisette and Cynthia together were called Listen. So we're working on that. We're working on some mixes. And I'm hoping that my partner that has joined my team will do some serious justice to this record and put a twist on it. So... Ted Moo is in the... What, Ted? Ted asked me a good question earlier today. I went on his IG Live, and he asked me, what's one of my favorite freestyle records? And it's not really freestyle. I mean, it is, but I said the Mexican. And I'm talking about the original Mexican with those crazy... Yeah. Those crazy beats. I love... I come from that. I love, like, the hardcore, dirty drums... And her vocal and that mix, that marriage was insane. So we were trying to figure out who Chico Fernandez is. And he's funny. So he had to call his peeps. There were a whole bunch of people chiming in. So shout out to Ted. Ted has been part and has become a friend. Jessie is an entrepreneur. She's doing her thing. So shout out to you guys too. And I just have to give shout out. That's all. So. I have to keep this moving because time did fly, and I really want to talk to my my piece to my puzzle, my team player. We need to ask him some questions so we can introduce him to my world, which people are going to know anyway. But for those that don't, it's a new beginning, and not everybody that he's going to bring to the table know who I am. So we're trying to cross both worlds and see what we can create. And we do have chemistry because I heard some things, and I can't keep it a secret any longer, that he did with some of my stuff. And I was like, oh, this is ridiculous. So it's meant to be, and I believe timing is everything. Timing is everything, and there's a reason why things do happen. And there's certain people that, like Rex 3 Entertainment is one, again, part of the team. And he is also like one that I always tell him, listen, things do happen for a reason. Sometimes he doesn't want to hear it, but it's reality, yo. We don't understand why things happen, and they just do. I'm not trying to create a kumbaya moment. You don't have to join the team. Whatever you need to do, follow your heart, do what you do. I know what I want to do. But we are going to have to bring, amen. So gym sounds, oh, I can't uprock. I have no room to uprock. I have my Adidas on, I have my hat on, because I'm not trying to, you know, do the hair thing, I'm trying to just rock out. So let's pump up the music, Chico Fernandez, right? I know who Chico Fernandez.
Check one, Rex 3 Entertainment is in the building. Give some shout outs. Robert Barco is watching us tonight. What's up, Robert? FMR DJs, all the FMR DJs in the building right now watching. Big shout out to Freeze. Frank Blazer is watching. Big shout out to Cynthia, the dream girl herself. Special guest, 2 minutes. Let's go, chop it up. Come on now. New York Knicks, always representing. Big George in the building. Big George, you want some coffee? Carlos Berrios is in the building. Let's go, we're making history, people, tonight. We're making history. We're bringing this to another level. This freestyle genre, we're bringing it to another level, no doubt. Let's go. Who's with me? Sal Batello was supposed to sign on. Somebody help him sign on. Franny Fran. Angelica. I see you. Somebody get C-Bank on here. Let's go, people. Hit that share button. Let's go. Hit that share button. Jim Sounds in the building. Hit him, Jim Sounds. He's on various times. He lets you know when he's going to go on. Hit him, Jim. Shout out to Coro, he's always making it happen. Looking good. Angelica, I see you. Always out there representing. Let's go, people, share. Benny B. Benny B is in the building. Oh, you didn't just kill him with Noel. Did you just kill him with Noel? That's what I'm talking about, Jim Sounds. If you're a DJ lover, start hitting some DJs up. Let's get some DJs on tonight, because we have a special guest. Any DJs out there, start hitting your boys up. All DJs in the building. Let's go. Lori, is that you? Oh, you didn't just drop Shannon. You know you can't play her too long. They're gonna boot us. Give them 3 seconds of Shannon and then spin it. Let's go, people. Let's share. Somebody call Sal Batello. He's trying to get on. Guide him through the process, people. Very little of the cover girls, very little. We do not want to get booted. Lisette Melendez is in the building. Ladybug Records in the building. Richie Rich, the bad boy, is in the building. What up, Richie? I see you.
With DJ Jim Sound on Freestyle Music Radio.
Hey, Richie, I got a question for you. Why are you the bad boy, and why is your hair so damn fly? You got the flyest hair of any DJ out there. What's up, my peoples? My name is Rex. Rex Entertainment is in the building. And I just want to give a special shout out to this man right here. He's doing it for us every single day, every single week. So Jimmy, you're very talented, very gifted. And Ladybug Records, Rex Entertainment, we love what you do. And we're so happy to have you part of our team. And special guest coming to join our team, the Rex 3 and Ladybug family, in 1 minute. So hit him with something hard, and here we go.
You're the one my heart beats for.
Big shout out to Betsy and Larry V. They make so much happen. Noel, the Wepa man. What up, Wepa? Noel. We're gonna get booted. We're gonna get booted. TST is in the building. TST. All right. Shout out to Lisa, Brenda, and Judy Torres.
So we are gonna bring Red Street. Say what's up. Come in, Red Street. We're gonna lower everything now. I don't want this to end because I know once this happens, I'm not gonna want to get off. And I don't mean get off in that way. I'm not gonna want to get off. Way that I feel.
Check.
Will you still be in love, baby?
1, 2, 1, 2.
You think you're gonna be
check
ready?
One.
Check we one. Go. We're gonna do this now. Okay. Let's drop it. There's too much going on right now. We're gonna keep this moving. Thank you for hanging in there, for checking me out, for supporting LM in the house. I've come a long way, and it's because of you, and it's because of all the DJs that have shown me love all these years, y'all. So with that being said, I really want to just extend my gratitude. Jam only.
Check.
Oh, he's playing jam.
Wait. Before we announce this person. Jimmy Jam. Before we announce this person, I just want to say a couple of things about this beautiful, talented legend. And she keeps doing it day in and day out. She gave you 2 new songs. You asked for it. You want new freestyle. She gave you not 1, but 2 new songs that are awesome. And I just want to say on behalf of Rexer Entertainment that I'm proud of you day in and day out in what you do. And you're a great mother, you're a great wife, and you're a great artist. And you got more to give the people out there. So I know you're not done yet, right?
I'm not done. You hear that, ladies? It's all about the ladies. We multitask. I know I do a lot more than I should, and I get in trouble for it. But that's my nature. You can accomplish whatever you choose to, and I believe that timing is everything. And right now, and the right team, of course, and the right team. So I have worked, and we've worked on creating and carefully talking and being very choosy as to who we let in our circle, because I'm particular and I have to keep my guard up. You know, I'm very forgiving, so I am not going to harp on anything negative, and that's not what I'm about. We can do that all day. We don't want to do negativity.
So without further ado, this person has been in the business for over 30 years. Yo, we can't even give him a proper introduction, so we're going to be out. Here you go. Eddie B. Swift is in the building.
He's gonna eat his food, and to me, I thought about it long and hard because I get in trouble all the time because I always tend to piss somebody off, whether I mean to or not. And then he is a very energetic, expressive, talented individual. So I think together we are going to be a force. Well, you do have a lot of pasta on the side of your mouth. I'm not gonna tell you what that looks like, but it does. It doesn't look too attractive.
But they can't hear us.
Are we on yet?
Check, we should be good.
Are we good? I hope so.
We switched laptops up here. Eddie B's laptop busted out.
We were doing just fine until we plugged his laptop in. Now, see, now that means we're going to blow shit up.
Hey.
Okay, so we need to know if you can hear us. Are we good?
Hey, DJ Freeze, can you hear us, DJ Freeze? It's back. All right, it's back.
All right, so sound is back. Okay, so I got to watch what I say. So Sal is 2019. He's in 2019 now. So Sal, big ups to Sal.
Sal, for president.
He's been doing his thing for quite a while.
Make America great, Sal.
So that's...
All right, you're gonna have to.
We are going to talk. We need to talk to Eddie B. And we need. So you're gonna have to put it away, because we do have to educate our fans as to what you've done. Just a little quick thing, so he can just explain to you what he's been doing for the past 25, 30 years plus. And that's it, you know? Because every you guys already did too. You keep telling me that I've been in the business.
I've been lying about my age for the past 30 years. Are we doing it like that?
So, but listen, no, I'm going to have, I think we should have, you want to have Rex 3? Why don't you sit down here and talk
we're gonna
to
me? No, we're going to do a little bit. They want to see you. They don't want to see me.
Take a picture, post it on IG.
They want to see. But you could tag, you know what? Give them the mic a little bit. We're going to interview Eddie B. Swift because.
Only for now. Oh, damn. You just got me all loud and shit. Brought me in.
So for those of you that don't know who Eddie B. Swift is, Eddie, you're now on Monday nights at a certain time. What time are you on Monday nights?
8 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time for the people on the East Coast. 5 p.m. Pacific Time.
And you're down with the FMR DJs, correct?
Yes, I am doing a show on that channel. I have to be careful because the lawyer told me I had to say certain things properly. I don't want to get nobody in trouble, no lawsuits, anything. Yes.
So Eddie, where you from? Where you grew up? So people understand that you're just not a new jack coming into the business. You know,
right.
If they don't know you, what you've been doing.
Well, I mean, like most people, I grew up in a house, two parents, brothers, sisters. We had a bathroom. I had a dog named Jackie. Very interesting. A beagle. I had a Snoopy who was a mutt. Don't ask me how that happened. But no, let me stop playing around. I grew up in the Bronx, South Bronx, that is, right around Hunts Point. No, I didn't hang out with the hookers. I was just in the area, not too far from there. I didn't start DJing at the Wedge. I started DJing in my room, which also got me thrown out at an early age. No, that's not true. I'm trying to add elements of surprise here because, you know, again, most people who know me know I don't take, yeah, that's it. I don't want to talk, interview's over. Let me stop.
Bam, that was.
Now, well, you know what, bottom line is, all right, I was born in the Bronx. I'm oldest.
What part of the Bronx?
South Bronx, right around Monroe High School where Colin Powell went to. Just had to throw that in there. I went to that esteem school. I dropped out of there, so nothing really happened from there. I did not sell drugs. I was a break dancer, and when break dancing was going out of style, it was either a Webo dance wearing with the Webo boots, oh, yeah, with the feather in the back, a pair of AJs, the two-toned joints, and a Latigre with a white glove. I had one white glove.
But you didn't have the leaves with the permanent?
No. I had the permanent crease, yes. Pinstripe permanent, but I also used to take shoelaces and put the straight leg myself. So, you know.
So listen, give us a little history of like what DJs, what clubs you DJed at.
Oh wow!
What time when you started DJing?
Man, you know, DJs different than from back then. Man, come here. We ain't gonna do this shit like this, Rob. We gonna talk here. First of all, let me first start by saying this. This is my boy Rob, who's now representing me. So we're gonna get that out of the way right now. The handshake is official. There it goes. Now I'm gonna interview you, Rob. He doesn't know me, really. Now, let me start. So, I started off playing in the Kips Bay Boys Club. And one of the first shows I did was Cover Girls. And that was the first place I played at. Then, Baby...
What year was that?
In the 80s, but don't ask me dates, because my...
86, 87?
When they first dropped. Like, they were performing at Kips Bay Boys Club. You know they wasn't banging yet.
It was 86.
It was just Show Me, and that's it. It was the one song, In and Out, and we was done. But, I started off there, and Baby Heck, who I used to work with in a record store in Castle Hill called DJ Specialty, gave me my break along with David Morales in a club called The Red Zone. That was the first time that I officially played in a club. Then I went on to do clubs like El Morocco, Home Base, Palladium, Latin Quarters, Studio, the Copa, the original Copa.
Red Zone. Let's not forget Red Zone.
Well, Red Zone, yes. And then, let's see.
Latin Quarter.
Man,
is there any club you have not DJed at?
In New York, I pretty much did all of them. You know, they just changed their name so many times. Like, Latin Quarters was in like three different locations, but I was fortunate to play in them. Lamar East, the Copa, Emerald City was another one that was in 59th Street.
So let's fast forward 1996.
Yes.
You do something special. Now, if you don't know, because you see him on Facebook and you see him doing his thing, and you also got the, you know, you got your own channel going on, right?
Yes, sir.
But people don't know, in 1996, before there was real Facebook.
When all you old people.
It was just AOL. Wait, can you make the AOL noise, like, you know when you sign on?
That annoying shit.
Yeah.
I just said it.
AOL. What happened to you?
It was the first time that I DJed online. I was offered presented an opportunity to play music online, which I thought would never be allowed. But you know, I was transitioning because at that time, turntables, CDJs were now being introduced, and I kind of like wasn't a fan of that. So I was like, I'm gonna stay away from this. And that was presented to me as an opportunity. So we had a T3 line and a big fiber optic cable, like an elephant trunk. We used to run through my house, and we kind of like just started playing online. And it was a successful venture for a long time because that allowed me to continue DJing. Probably wasn't for that. I probably would have quit early. It was a different platform. It was new. And when I would get emails from people, because my email back then was eddiebswift@aol.com, which I still have, but I don't know if it still works. But everything goes to spam, but I don't do spam. I do this from time to time, Rob, so don't do this. Like, don't get mad at me. I don't want to get fired before my first day even starts. But Rob, you Rob's too serious. Rob doesn't laugh enough. I've noticed that. On the phone, he's laughable, but we're serious right now, and he's trying to conduct a serious interview.
I want the people to get to know who you are, because all of a
this
sudden...
This is who I am, so...
No, but I'm saying all of a sudden, like, who's this DJ on Monday nights at 8 o'clock talking all this yang, and who is he, and he's wearing glasses, and all the craziness and stuff?
Well...
I'm good. No, I'm good.
What you...
I'm trying to undress me. I'm good.
I don't know what I walked into. When I walked in, it was normal. Now.
So now, we're bringing you out.
Yes.
And letting them know.
Introducing me.
Introducing you. So, all right. So, you started with 1996.
Right.
You started, you know, the Bobito show. You've done a lot of different things.
I've been blessed to have those kind of opportunities.
You've been blessed. Now, Cypress Hill. Let's go 10 years back. If you don't know, this is the Cypress Hill DJ.
Now, hold on. Let me start the misconception, because Mixmaster Mike is the actual show DJ.
You know what? I like that, though, because you could have been like, yo, I'm the only
DJ.
Right?
Hell no. People fact check, and they'll call you a liar real quick. I can't say no more. Hold on. I don't want to get in trouble with my lawyer. I don't want to get in trouble with my lawyer. Don't push those buttons.
Listen, you signed to Rex 3 Entertainment, and there's a clause in there.
You know what?
Right?
I forgot that you can handle. I'm sorry. You know what it is?
But I'm saying there's a clause in there. The clause is... We don't mention no negativity, right?
I didn't mention any negativity.
No,
I don't want to get in trouble. No, me dale papá ahora.
I didn't say you did.
El primer día, wow.
So now you're on Monday.
I can't breathe.
Now you're on Monday nights, but before your Monday nights, you're out there with
Cypress Hill. I still do, yeah. So what happens is I kind of like the opener set DJ. I'm the default hype person, you know, instead of going to a town where you're sweating, you're sudando.
That's part of the Rex 3 Entertainment.
Wow. Except, you
know,
you
can pat it down and that's it. But I'm just saying like that.
In my contract, it said it was going to be women with the feathers and the fan like this.
Listen, that's coming.
They haven't come yet. I got it.
That's part of your contract.
Got it.
You know.
So I was set up, you know, basically give energy to the crowd. So by the time Cypress come out, it's fucking lit. And, you know, sometimes, unfortunately, when you go to towns and you hire local talent, they don't match your energy. So instead of being caught in that situation, I was given an opportunity by B Real, who is the lead singer Cypress, to DJ, you know, for the fans, and it's worked out well, and I'm still continuing to have a great run. They're out on tour right now. Hold on, I know this is a shameless plug, but West Coast High Tour right now. They're in Phoenix tonight, and just go to CypressHill.com.
Listen.
Yes, sir.
The bread and butter?
Yes.
You got to shout them out.
Absolutely, right? Absolutely.
So, shout out Cypress?
But, of course. I mean, you know, first off, man, condolences to B-Real's moms, man. Unfortunately, she passed away in the middle of tour, but, you know, he's a professional, and man, just prayers to my dude, man. But, you know, they gave me the opportunity to really shine. Like, I had De La Soul before them, you know, Maceo, and being involved in these type of projects, man, is always great. You know, I love to see people put together things that where a team wins. You know, it's all about a great team. Once you surround yourself with good people, good things tend to happen. So being with De La Soul and then going with Cypress, I've been fortunate, you know, until this day. I'm still rocking with them. Monday through Friday, B-Real TV. Facebook Live page. I throw the clips on it. Like, if you go to my IG, it's nothing but those posts. And now freestyle posts, which we're going to get into right now.
Why don't you give a shout out to a couple of DJs that you've worked with in the past and you're working with now?
I mean, everybody from Kenny Dope to Ted, Ted Smooth, Boogie Blind, Mel Star. You know what it is? I feel funny because these are like my personal friends. So to start shouting them out, you know, I got too many DJ friends and, you know, I've worked with all of them, man. There's not a DJ I haven't worked with. I even worked with a lot of the new ones, like the more current ones, like Incrediboy, Philly Phil. I mean, a lot of great young DJs out there, you know. But I'm still running the old man circuit, so You can catch me on the Jared Tour, retirement tour soon after the whole Lisette thing finishes. But we're not there yet. We're still in 2000 something.
We're here now, right?
Yes, sir.
We don't want to bore them.
Not at all.
All right.
First of all, I don't find myself boring.
I just say we don't want to.
Oh no, we're not gonna bore them. This is not like watching paint dry.
Right now, you're hysterical. You're not delusional. You're not delusional.
I'm all over the place.
But you're hysterical.
Well, you know, that's what happens.
But I'm gonna ask you.
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna name an artist to you,
right?
And I want you to tell me. Look at that camera right there, because you called and spoke. Maybe we've been talking about 2 weeks. We've been talking back and forth. Lisette Melendez. What does that person, that artist, mean to you when that name is set? Because we've talked in.
Well, it's funny because, you know, again, Lisette came out back in the days, and you weren't married yet. And we always, Lisette Melendez was the poster girl in a lot of young Puerto Rican DJs' room. You know what I'm saying? So I don't want to sound like, oh, creepy, no. But, you know, when I first seen her.
First of all, that did sound kind of creepy, but that's all right.
I didn't say that I had the one where she was cleaning the car, the album cover. See, I was a DJ, so I put album covers on my wall. And hers was featured prominently because the other artists couldn't have pictures. Like, I don't think I saw Judy Torres until like 5 years after the fact. Yes.
No. Has to do an interview at 10 o'clock.
Oh, damn. Oh.
No. He's going to stay on, and he's actually going to. He's got a surprise for us. We got the turntable set up.
Right now, what he's doing is queuing up the music that they get at the Grammys when they're telling the artist to hurry up and move along.
He's gonna show
I'm going to talk while he's talking right now. They're both going to talk. We're all going to talk right now. Is that
on what he does.
Well, hold on a second.
But listen,
I'm not high. I'm not high.
Lisette Melendez, what does she mean to you?
She is the epitome of versatility. She is a woman who's adaptable to any type of situation.
Can you take that word from me, versatility?
On the phone conversation?
Yeah.
Isn't that what you paid me to say?
Okay. Part of the contract.
No, I've seen her perform from when she first came out to even now, and she's one of the few freestyle acts that I know that have actually has changed. You know, she's always been a game changer. So, you know, to me, I've seen the development as a DJ, as a fan, you know, not a fan now, because I know her, so like that, I don't got to say I'm a fan anymore. I just say that's my friend, that's my homegirl, her husband's my peoples, that's my manager, and yep, let's go, next question.
First of all, I want to thank you for giving me that opportunity. I called you 2 days ago, and you got to strike while the iron is hot, people. Take advantage of an opportunity,
did
right?
I leave my iron on?
And
Well,
listen, timing, but the opportunity is there. When I have somebody call me and say, listen, your wife is an icon. I believe in her. I've been doing this for 30 years. I've toured all over the world. I've seen various artists.
I was drinking that night.
I've worked with the biggest artists, right? I've worked with the biggest artists.
I know a few of them.
I've worked with not so big artists, right?
I thought you said we're not going to talk about that.
Wait, but you've treated them all the same, right?
Everybody gets treated the same, and at the end of the day, if it wasn't for them, there would be no us. There would be no opportunity like this. You know, we'd just be people passing in the street. You know, but fortunately that we've developed a fan base. I don't even consider them fans. I consider them my peoples. You know, they're my friends, extended family. At the end of the day, and they're the ones that brought us to this position right now. Because if it wasn't for that scenario, I wouldn't have met Jim. Jim would not connect me to them.
I just want to. It all started with Julio Mena. When I called Julio Mena 6 months ago, and he's been out in the game for a minute, and I told Julio, I said, listen, you got a manager? And we went back and forth on cross-promotion, and I said, listen, let's work with each other for a minute. You know, let's see how it is. Because that's how it is. Even with me and you, I want you to feel comfortable.
Like, I absolutely do.
I want to feel comfortable working with you.
I don't think he feels comfortable yet because he thinks I talk too much.
No, I actually do. I actually got you the lasagna and all that, you know, today. But that's all right. The shrimp. I went out. I was like, what do you want to eat? He's like, shrimp. He was very detailed. But anyway, Julio Mena, big shout out to him. He's got new music coming out. We're actually going to play his music a little bit later on. But he started. We went back and forth. Very talented. A lot of connections. Does his thing. He's got a great voice. So he introduces me to Jimmy Sounds.
Okay.
Okay, Jimmy comes part of the team with Julio. Now Jimmy Sounds is on the team, right? Yes. What does Jimmy do? He picks up the phone, right? Or inboxes you, right?
Jimmy hit me up at this point and was like, hey, what's up, man? I like what you're doing, whatever have you. And as with anybody that's ever reached out to me in a DM, except the chicks, I really don't do that because I get in trouble every time that happens. But Jim hit me up. I decided to talk to him because he came at me. He approached me like everybody always had some... They have some what's the word I'm looking for? an agenda.
No, ulterior motive.
Yes, that. But the lawyer told me I couldn't say that word because I don't know how to say it. Because
that's what I'm saying.
I didn't put on the good teeth today.
It's too big for you. That's a T word.
You know what it is? I got my hip hop teeth today.
Ulterior motive.
Yes, thank you. So you know, he reached out to me, man, and it's humbling to talk to somebody, you know, especially fellow DJs that. You know, he hit me up, and I hit him back, man, and we just started chopping off and hit it off quickly. Like, I hit him up, and we doing a show on FMR a couple of days later. So, Jim, let me ask you a couple of questions.
Big shout-out to Jim. No. Wait.
Yeah, hit me on.
We're still on the set.
Okay.
So now we're going to fast forward to now.
Right.
And you've talked about your vision and what you see doing, and you know you've toured, you've been with other artists, you see how it is doing it really big, and your vision right now, and you don't want to give too much because we want to surprise right. the fans.
Absolutely.
And we want to surprise the people, but you are now her official DJ, right?
And you know what, right now I would hug her, but I'm gonna have to hug you because you're here. So he did that on purpose, though.
So EBS
yes.
is now, and you called us, and you're like, yo, this is what I want to do.
Yes.
You are the official Lisette Melendez, Ladybug, Rex 3 Entertainment.
Yes.
Official DJ.
Yes.
And you're going to be up there spinning, and I could just imagine, you know what I'm saying, what craziness is
if
you happen.
And I know a lot of people watching the page have been to her show, and they're great shows and so forth, but I think it's time now, before it becomes stale, you know, because freestyle is a genre that's been around for a while, but the genre has aged with the artist. So I feel like once the core, you know, a group that started out with start fading out, the genre unfortunately will. If we don't switch up and give them something different so the younger generation can now catch on, you know. And once you get the younger generation, that's how music lives on forever, man. And there's a lot of freestyle music that was made to live on. Anything that TKA does, anything that Lizette has done, Judy, Cynthia, Johnny O, all those great artists, Joey Kidd, shout out to him, Duran Ramos.
Shout out to Noel.
Noel also.
Big
I mean,
shout out. You know
just, I mean, the list goes on and on, man. Like, as a DJ, I could probably name like 100 freestyle artists. But, you know, for the most part, all that great music, without the proper participation from the people that listen to the genre, is gonna die a slow death, and it's not fair because it's such a great genre.
Right.
There's so much greatness here, and it gets lost in the shuffle. You know, everybody's hip hop, everybody's rock, everybody's top 40, everybody's EDM. You know, and freestyle is kind of like just coasted along. So you know, now that we're putting this in place, fuck that, we ain't coasting along no more. Now we're gonna raise the bar. We're gonna level up. We're gonna force other people to really get on their game and start putting out great shows. So now, you know, everybody's fighting to be the headliner, you know, because everybody's got that look. Everybody can start putting out new music, because in order to grow from where we're at, of course, new music is necessary. So, you know, like with Rise and all of that stuff. And then also some of the songs that might have gotten overlooked,
right.
You know, like back in the days, you know, Goody Goody was one of those songs that came out. I think that was at the time of a transition to label after
that
Profile.
93, 94.
Right, that was after Profile.
So
she did Goody Goody on Profile.
No, she was on Def Jam.
Yes, that's
Def Jam.
That's what I was getting to.
Fever Records. Let's not forget Fever.
Yes.
Columbia. It was like slash this, slash that, you know. Because back in the days,
she was a major artist. Put it that way.
Know,
I mean,
yeah.
Cap, Columbia, that's major, Sony, all of that stuff. So when she dropped that record, because of promotions, a lot of records like kind of like just fall by the wayside. And a lot of great records have like that. There's a lot of records that didn't happen to me like maybe 3 years after the fact. And you know, it did. It was popping when it was out, you know, and maybe now it's time to reintroduce that with a different vibe. You know what I'm saying? Different energy, you know, because it was a great song. You know, very sing-songy, you know, it was something they could relate to. And it's also a change of pace, because you always can't be the freestyle. Is that you got to show, in order to be show your versatility, you got to do songs like that. Or like the Latin stuff that she was doing with Sergio.
Door.
You know what I'm saying? And then anything that you get into, man, to open up your versatility, you know, is always a good thing. And people always don't respond the same. But if you repackage it and give it to them how they can understand it now, man, we can add another 20 years.
Well, talking about now,
yes,
you're an established DJ, been doing it for over 30 years.
Damn, there goes again the aging thing.
But you know what? You know what? I got to give it up, because people think, like, people were hitting you up, and I saw the chats, and they were like, yo, who's this new Jack? Like, you know, he just came into the game, and he's over here, and everybody, there was a little bit of jealousy. There was a little bit of animosity. I got to stop you, because I know you're getting ready to throw up. You know,
he knows me already.
Calm down. I already know him already. And when you manage somebody, you got to look at the tails, you know, and being a manager is about representing and about being that buffer, right?
Yo, he just impressed me right now, Jim. That impressed me.
You
gotta
be the buffer because I need him to continue doing his thing, right? And
yes.
And I don't want him calling me up and it's like, yo, Rob, can you mail me or wire me $250 because I'm locked up, right? Those days are over, right?
I don't think it, no. You know what? I did get arrested one time, but it was for
okay,
the petty
we're
shit.
Not, we're not gonna talk about that. But established DJ, I gotta ask you a question because shout out to TST, shout out to Carlos Berrios, Lisette. She wanted to do something new for her fans, and she got creative, and she really worked this, got worked up, and it was like, when I tell you that she wasn't sleeping, she wasn't eating, she wasn't like, she was just going crazy because she, it was all about Rise and all about the Rise remix. You're established DJ. How do you feel about those two records when you hear them?
Well, for me, it's different because, you know, it's been a long time since I've heard anything new. Like some of the artists, and I'm not speaking of Julio Mena, but a lot of the new artists are trying to like reinvent the wagon wheel, going away from the concept, the cadence of what freestyle really is. And I think that comes with experience. So I didn't gravitate towards the newer freestyle, but then when an accomplished artist like Lisette comes along, you tend to pay attention, like, okay, let me give her that courtesy listen, you know, because everything at first is always the element of surprise. But as a DJ who likes to break records, I heard it and I was like, oh, wow. You know, it's not that far off from what she's done. You know, it's just now back in the 80s and 90s when they were writing freestyle songs, it was always about relationships. It was always about lost loves or true loves or anything like that. This became just the mature version of Lisette, where she went out and is talking about, you know, issues today, like with women empowerment and stuff like that, you know, and that's something to
domestic,
commend.
Also domestic violence, which is big. You know, what she wants to do now, and I'm glad that you came into her life, our life, and you're part of the team, and we're putting this mogul team together, and that's the way I look at it. We got to go big.
Yes.
If we're not going to go big, we're just going to go home. But, you know, she wants to help, you know, domestic violence women. She wants to do things for, you know, for battered women. She wants to be the face of bullying. And it's just so funny because, you know, throughout this whole Rise record and Rise remix and everything, she's been bullied left and right. And me being not only her manager but also her husband, I've seen it, you know, and I try to be as supportive as I can without just, you know, getting ugly, right? Because
you have to separate yourself as being a husband and then being the musical.
You got to remain professional.
Right,
you know?
Correct.
But I've seen her hurt. You know, and to hear you say, and, you know, we spoke this week and you're like, look, I like the record. I think it's great. I think it's a great message, you know. And I asked you, I said, would you play it? Would you play the record?
Yes.
You know, and you told me straight up, you're like, yo, I would have it on rotation. I would play it for two reasons. You told me two reasons. You said because she's Lisette Melendez and she's already proven herself and she wants to do new music for her fans. And the message alone is important because it's about the women. And all the women out there that are watching right now, domestic violence or whatever, you know, it's a serious cause. You know, I'm sorry that you're going through what you're going through. Know there's help out there for you. And Lisette wants to be your voice.
I think they don't post like some numbers and stuff, you know, for stuff like that, just in case you're not informed
about
that.
Well, it's on her video. At the end of her video, there's a number on there.
There you go.
That you can look at, you know. So, you know, I'm proud of her. I say it every day. You know, we'll eat breakfast and or lunch or dinner, whatever it is, and I look at it, I'm like, babe, I'm proud of what you've done, what you've accomplished, what you continue to accomplish. And now, just bringing you, Jim Sounds, Julio Mena, just bringing us down, you know, as part of the team. You know, and we still have Carlos Berrios that we work with, and we still
phenomenal
have TST.
Dude, phenomenal dude.
You know, TST. You know, there are people in our circle and the DJs that are out there that have been supporting us since day one. I thank you. You know, all the FMR DJs, the Richie Riches of the world, the Tim Shomers of the world, you know, that are out there. Every
all the DJs
DJ.
That support freestyle as a whole, man. You know, there's a lot out there that we don't get to see on the basis, but they're supporting their own ways. And those are the ones I really like to thank because they are a continuing music genre that, again, needs help right now. Right. And I think what we're going to start is a step in the right direction. And hopefully the community will embrace it because at the end of the day, it's different. I you know, I'm a proponent of, you don't scratch during house music, you don't scratch during this, but if it's done tastefully, you know, and sometimes I might extend it a little bit more than what it is, but it's just me having fun, me showing you my personality. When I'm interpreting a song, taking an acapella from a well-popular song, it could be anything with Judy, and mix it with Justin Timberlake, it's just like picturing what it would sound like in the year 2000, you know, 2010, 2019. And it just gives you the idea that it would be great if we would just be a little bit more open to change. And a lot of times people are afraid to change because it's like, damn, I eat pizza and I put salt on it, but you know, put garlic on it tomorrow. It might taste a little bit better to you. Don't be afraid to try something different. And if you're afraid, then why bother? You know, you want to go to these things, you want to enjoy yourselves. But if you've seen the show in 2000 and that same artist, you saw him again perform 10 years later, it's pretty much the same show, you know. And you got to commend people like Judy, people like Lisette, people like Cynthia, who have changed with the times as far as the show performers. But now we're going to tweak it just a little bit more and add an element that's going to leave you like, wow. Like, we want you to feel like you just want to get up and dance in the aisles. You know, all these big concerts that they have in Radio City, you know, it's hard to watch that because this is not a genre of people to sit back and listen to and enjoy. You want to dance. I mean, that freestyle was created so we can continue to dance. You know, that buffer between, if you don't like hip-hop or salsa, you know, something danceable that, you know, us as young Latin people and white people and, you know, eventually black people came up aboard once, you know, we started having those kind of artists. It was just, you embraced it, man. That's what you wanted. And we wanted to bring that energy back when you first heard that.
Well, listen, big shout out to all the promoters out there like Sal Batello, Zeke and Kathy, you know, Kelly from Chicago, all the big promoters that are out there doing it big, continue doing it big, Alan Beck, that are out there bringing the freestyle out there, the genre. But we want to challenge, right? We want to challenge the artists, right?
Time
because
level
for
up.
The fans, we want to level up, you know, get your show right, you know, get it popping, put some money into back into your show.
Can I talk to a couple of DJs right now?
Back into your artistry.
So, you know, like, Lisette is not the first person to have a DJ. Let's be clear. Like, other artists have DJs, but they haven't made them interactive. And that's not to take...
I'm going to have to buff you from it and buffer...
No. This is not negative at all because...
Okay. I just want to make sure.
I'm going to say this. I love White Boy, who rocks with Cover Girls. I love Blaze, who rocks with Cynthia. You know what I'm saying? But it's time that we start stepping up and leveling up ourselves so like that the DJ part of these shows can be just that. Right. Not just standing behind there and just queuing up the next song. Like, yo, I know the DJs can add a certain element, you know, to buffer. I mean, one thing that I know, we are all aging together. We're pretty much all in the same age bracket. So as you're leveling up, you want to make sure that everybody's coming with you. You don't want to leave nobody behind.
Right.
And, you know, at the end of the day, I want White Boy to whip, kick ass when he's rocking and blazing to do his thing because that just levels up everybody else. And it's just like, all right, you did that today. All right, I got you. I'm going to do this today. Oh, word, you did that? I'm going to do this. And we all are bringing the energy into that. And I think that's right now we need to get back into it. We need that energy. You know, we're there to assist the artists and make it easier for them because if the artist is having an easier time, better the performance. The better the performance, the more times you get to see them. The more we switch it up, it brings versatility to the table. And then it allows them to say, hey, you know what? This shit's going good. I feel like we need to go in the studio and make another record. And that starts happening.
Oh, by the way, big plug. You got your mixtape, right?
Oh.
Mixtape, excuse me.
I was going to get into that.
1980. You got your mix CD, USB, and all that coming out with,
yes,
with my man Jim Sounds over there.
Yes,
and putting it together.
To be truthful, I get hit up all the time. Ed, make me a tape. I'm like, yeah, I'm going to send it to you. I still owe people tapes from like 20 years ago. And I'm going to send you a free download link. Trust me. But, you know, as now I'm coming into a genre where I'm not established like the artist. I'm established as a DJ. But, you know, part of my versatility is I'm proficient when it comes to freestyle music. I interpret it the way I like to hear it. Doesn't mean you got to like it, but you'll respect it. And if you respect it and give it a chance and let it marinate, it'll make you more open to future projects. And you'll be excited as not only to see the artist, but to see the stage shows. Because what that element does to the crowd, it's going to be electric, right? And
listen, I'm looking forward to it. I know the fans are.
I just want to get to it already, man.
Listen, because not for nothing, the fans are everything. And
yes,
what they do on these big shows that people put together is, I know you go out and there's like 8-10 of you. You go to dinner first, and then you go to the show at 8 o'clock because you got your kids at home, and you rock out for like 2-3 hours, and then you run back home. It's not like back in the days you're breaking night. You're back home by 11:30, 12 o'clock, and you just want to be nostalgic, and you just want to hear the songs that made you laugh, made you cry,
made,
right?
You think about what you was doing at that time when that record came out.
Yeah. So, you know, shout out to all the fans out there because I think it's important. Without the fans, we there is no DJ, right? There is no promoter. There is no, you know, artistry. There's nothing out there. There's no Rexstreet Entertainment. There's no management company. And I think that's important. You know, there's no booking agent. So the fans, thank you. We're looking to do something different. We're going to challenge the team. Julio Mena's being challenged. Lisette Melendez being challenged.
Time to level up.
My man right here is being challenged. And you guys are going to put something together.
I got challenged last week.
You got challenged. No.
No. Hold on. Wait, time out. This is not a bad thing. I got challenged to do a good show on FMR.
Okay.
That's right.
All right.
See? You already jumped to the conclusion, man. Come on, man. Give me a little credit.
Listen. The one thing we are going to discuss is we're just leaving everything alone. It's not like, listen, because people keep calling you. They're like, yo, you know, any beef out there, you got squash it, this and that. You know, we're not even talking about that no more.
But believe this, though. I do want to extend an actual, I'm not going to say apology.
No. Not buffering that.
No, we're not.
What,
no, but let me say this, though. I don't have no beef with nobody. Okay. Everybody that's there, man, I wish we all win. I don't care how big, how little you are. Everybody in this genre, I hope everybody wins. I don't have no issues with everybody. I just wish that, you know, we go about it in a way of positivity to bring the genre up, because we don't need no drama in this. Like, we all got issues, family life issues, and then you add that, it's going to turn people off. So.
Well, not only that, when we fight against each other, then we cannot bring this movement to another level.
Exactly. And that's kind of like what I was alluding to.
And that's what we need to understand, right? Everybody that's out there that has an ego, listen, we all have an ego, right? But we need to put the ego aside for a minute and want to build the genre up to another level, right? And you can't do that if I say, listen, I'm the best management company out there, and, you know.
I hope you are.
Well.
I do hope you are.
Listen to me. I'm going to give you 130% because that's what I do, and you deserve it.
I appreciate that, man.
And if you are locked up at 3 in the morning, I will go out there because Lisette knows. You know, nah, she's never been locked up. But you know, just the ego, you know, egos. Like, people like the egotistic, and they like the fight, and they like the drama, and that's okay. We're gonna bring you drama, but we're gonna bring you drama in the right way. You know, we're gonna give it to you the right way. My man right here. If you haven't seen him on the one and twos, we're gonna put you on the one and twos tonight. You all right with that? Are you okay?
I can play a couple of records.
Now, I'm going to challenge you tonight. Are you all right going on the one and two?
Yeah.
All right, because if not, I mean, let's just.
Jim just does a great job before.
Let's just rip it up.
He can get busy, but I'm going to play a couple of songs.
No, because I want the people. Listen, the reason why we did this tonight, and Lisette did it, and she wanted to bring you on, is because she wanted the people to know, first of all, who's going to be on her team, you know, and why you're being on the team. But secondly, and most importantly, we wanted the people to know who you are, because they see you and they just think, oh, this is the new DJ that just came out and just has beef with another DJ and whatever.
Nah.
This guy right here has been doing it, and I keep saying it, and it's not that you're old, it's just that you're mature and you've been doing it for years and years and years, and you've done so much and accomplished so much that people don't know. So do your homework, first of all. One thing I always tell people is,
he knows more about me than I know about myself. Right. I had to, like,
because before I even thought about making that phone call to him, I had to do my homework. You know, so I studied up on you. You know, I read. I was like, what is this guy all about? Because what I see him doing on the turntables, I was already impressed. But I needed to know the man behind the turntable. And, you know, we're going to do some future shows. Like, I want to bring Julia Mena in. I want Lisette to be more part of it. So you get to, you know, it's up close and personal. I think this is important for the fans.
Represent for the brand. Represent for the team.
And represent for the brand. But also, you know, just talk a little bit as we move forward what we want to do to the genre to bring it to the next level. And, you know, people always talk about this freestyle thing is going to be dead in 10 years. And you know, nobody's going to want to go see it. And they thought about that 20 years ago. You know, when I remember Adam Torres and Sal Batello did Madison Square Garden, and 18,000 people showed up that night, you know, and Club Essos, I think it was like 10,000 people, 8,000 people showed up to a club, you know, because all the freestyle artists just came back because they weren't booking them after, you know, like 3 or 4 years. And then Sal and everybody got together and said, listen, let's see what we can do.
And we're going to recreate that 2019 style.
So 2019, 2020, we challenge ourselves. Can you get on the one and twos for these people?
We'll do that right now.
I'm sure we talked so much, you know. So go ahead and head over. We're going to set up the cameras over to the side, and my man right here is going to do his thing. But again, real quick, before we done with all this, I just want to say I'm so proud of this individual for everything you've done for 30 years, for everything you've done for the music, and I'm so happy to have you part of the Rex 3. Ladybug family, and you know, we're gonna do such great things, man, and I'm really happy. So make it official. Make it official with the pound.
Let me get some ground to a different place.
Make it official?
Yes, sir.
All right, baby. So get on that 1 and 2, Papa. 1 and 2 is coming right now. So let's set up. How long you need to be set up over here? You good? So you're going to take it. You're going to take it straight. So let me get my phone out. While you're doing that, let me see if I get some shout outs to the fans, because that's what it's about. It's about the fans. So big shout out. Let's go. Shout out. Check one. Oh, so we back. So Brenda is in the building. A couple of shout outs over here because I want to give it out to the fans. Brenda's in the building. Tim Shoma is in the building. Thank you, Tim Shoma. Richie Rich is in the building. Big Blaze is in the building. Here, we're going to let Jim Sounds do this because he knows how to do this.
My peoples was good. Special roll call going out to Betsy, Larry, Larry V, EVZ, Barry Black, Rene Dioses Jr., Grimy, El Padrino. Special shout outs going out to my homie, Michael Fenwick, Eloisa Rosa, Tammy Creel, Josh JW, Erica Ortiz, Mentor Blazer One. Shout outs going out to Shy Jay Castillo. Special shout outs going out to Tamara Marin, Rick Corsino, Jesus Melendez. Test 1, 2. If you hear me, let me get a thumbs up. If you hear me, let me get a thumbs up. Special shout outs going out to they hear me. Okay. Erica Ortiz, New York Nick, DJ Tomate was good, Torres Nancy, Angelica Vells, Melissa My Sonet. Everybody, we're getting ready to go live. Had a little bit of an issue here, but we're about to get this popping. Angelica Vells, Robert DJ Cash was good. Shout out to Freestyle Music Radio. Shout out to Noel Mercado. Weba. A very, very special shout out to Julio Mena. And thank you so much for opening these doors. Hey, I won't let you down, brother. Let's do this.
Hey, yo, this is Greg and I'll see E in the place to be with Lisette Melendez doing it up right, you know. And this is another Fat Cat Productions, so we want y'all to follow us. Hey. I'm in desperate need. I'm in desperate need of love. It's real good love.
You would say gently,
Let me get a thumbs up.
Say a rhyme after the next one. Prepared, never scared, I'll just bless one. And you know that I'm the solo whistle, so Eric B, make a clap.
on a Thursday.
And all the rest of them scrapping for skill, I got gorillas protecting them. The niggas you connected to, Lord done connected them. Respected for doing the unexpected. Bronx man elect like Earl Simmons, I X shit. And detectives can't detect it. My credit, you can check it. The saga, do it or dead it.
And $100 billers. I got you stuck off the realness. Keep them show crews running like they supposed to.
I got you stuck
off the realness. They come around, but they never come close to you. You're minor, we major. Rock you in your face.
Can't you see the glow on the window pane? I can feel the sun whenever you're near. Every time you touch me, I just melt away. Everybody asks me why I'm smiling out from ear to ear. But I know, oh, love is perfect, but it's worth it after fighting through my tears. And finally, you put
the statement. You remember.
Since we've been friends in need and have a love we share in our hearts to try to keep us apart. Took some time to build this trust in me, but now you're all I care to think of. You want the best of my love. What you want to see, but please have the faith in me. Are we ready now? Together forever, yours. Jimmy Sal, together forever, my restory, facing what we feel inside. Take it home now. Ready to stand the test of time. Kilt.
shout out.
I could shout out. I could shout out, no? You know, I always forget people. Okay. All right. So, listen. Again, thank you all. A lot of this is spontaneous stuff. I never plan it. Sometimes those things work out best for me. But I definitely, definitely want to give a big shout out. Number one, Jim Sounds. If it wasn't for Jim Sounds, a lot of the stuff that I'm trying to accomplish wouldn't be possible, because I didn't have the patience or the time to do what he is best at. So I'm glad that Rex 3 Entertainment brought him into the team, because I'm very skeptical as to who I let in. So Jim Sounds, give me 5. Yo, absolutely. So I'm going to give, like I said, people, one at a time. So... Jim Sounds, first and foremost, because, you know, Jimmy, we try to do a lot of shit. Secondly, I want to, and it doesn't go according to number, so if you're number one or number four, it doesn't matter. I want to give a shout out to Julio Mena. Mena has crazy talent. He's a force to be reckoned with, but I do believe that he hasn't accomplished, and he has so much to offer, and this is only the beginning for him. So shout out, because he also gave me a lot of ideas with the Rise. As far as the artwork and everything, he stepped to the plate with that. He's
officially, now this is possible, it's not Julio
Mena. Right, so Julio Mena, big shout out. He has a big heart, and he's very he's very generous, and I gotta give, you know, props to people that are generous and they do not get intimidated by the next one. And that's the problem that we have sometimes. People do get intimidated. They don't want to share. It's all good. But now I'm coming in and, you know, I'm trying to establish a team and create a unit. And so far we are doing that. And I'm very thankful for you to come into my life and believing in me. We're going to have our ups and downs. So don't be shutting down your pages on me when you're not happy with anything that I may say.
Hold on.
So.
¿Puede coger comida para llevar? Con permiso.
Oh, you took my glass. Oh, hell. Oh.
Yo, we got to model this.
Oh, damn, I didn't know these twins.
Oh,
wow. Rise, it's all about the Rise.
Hold on, let me put my glasses on. Oh, her glasses.
Oh, those are the...
Listen, shizzle.
Time
out. Listen, we're missing my little brother out here. He's out there doing his video for this song. So we're going to end it with my little brother being in here. And we're just going to drop a little bit for him. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to get silly. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what we're about. But.
No, I got to raise this up. What was that, right? They left us, Jimmy. So anyway, we're giving shout out to Mena. Shout out to Jim Sounds. Eddie B. Swift. Eddie, you took great notes. I taught you. It took a while for me to teach him how to spin. And Jimmy, too. Jimmy, yeah. You learned. Thank you for
teaching me.
Yes,
school.
Yes.
I appreciate
yes,
it.
Yes, yes.
Thank you so much.
So we did our thing today. Like I said, it was kind of late, but better late than never. I want to thank you all for just supporting LM, right?
And joining us today.
And
thank you so much.
FMR DJs.
Shout out to all my FMR DJs. I love you guys. Much love and respect to you guys all.
That's right, y'all. So always, always FMR DJs, you know? And, you know, you can't get offended if I forget a few people, yo. I'm very forgetful. Remember that, but it doesn't come with intention. Rex 3 Entertainment, come in with Rex 3 Entertainment shirts, too. I have my Rye shirts.
Yo,
what are you?
Little bro, we miss you, little bro. Julio Mena.
Shout out to Julio.
None of this is possible without Julio.
None of it.
Right. Julio.
And
he went to make another plate.
And I do need some shrimp later. A veces se está comiendo. Se comió la.
No, I'm just kidding. Can I ask a question
online? I need
something real quick. Hold this thing. Did you pay for this plaque? I just want to know. Did
Did you pay for any of this?
Oh, you drop my plaques, you're gonna be in trouble, yo.
I know because
I paid. I paid too much money for that. No, I'm not serious.
That was it. No more.
No, but listen, listen. It's I have my awards downstairs too that I didn't bring up. I'm remodeling. I'm trying to change stuff up. I live very modest. It's all about what you feel, and I'm very thankful to have what I have. ¿Verdad? So I really don't want to get off, but I do want to get off. How do you take it however you want, but good night, y'all. Oh, he doesn't want to end it. Oh, he's...
I can enjoy my first plate. I'm going to enjoy my second plate. I ate the first plate, but I enjoyed it, but I didn't enjoy it, so I got a second plate. I'm going to taste test right now, and... What's that?
Back up, back up. I will tell you, signing this dude is going to cost me a meal plan. I'm going to have to put a meal plan together for this dude, because you're going to eat me out of house and home, Papa.
No, I'm Fat Boy Fresh. Just want to let you know. I'm Fat Boy
Yo,
Fresh.
But you are cut nice. You got a nice cut. You got a nice cut.
I did notice that he had a beard when he was live, and when he came here, he was all clean cut. I was like, wow.
I told him how proud I was of you, and you know, you've had sleepless nights. You know, you've been hard on yourself, but now you got your team together. You're gonna have to show them what you're gonna do. Are you ready?
I am, but I was missing because I had to do an interview. Did you touch base with the fans and let them know that we're ready to do our thing?
We hugged it out.
So listen, we do have shows coming up. We have several. So I would love to have Eddie rock with me, and it's gonna be spontaneous.
Hold on, this is my show right now. I'm telling y'all right now. Lizette's next show is our next show, and you ain't wanna miss that. If you ain't got your tickets yet, if you don't know where is the next show? Go to the Lisette Melendez. You're watching. You're on the page right now. All the tour dates is there. If everyone is not sold out, I will personally take Jim to your house and pick you up and bring you over there. No, I'm not, but I'm just saying that anyway. Here you go.
Well, I do have Miramar coming up. I have, which I'm really bad, and I apologize to promoters. I try to give shout-outs to as much as I can. I do have Miramar the 23rd, Miami, and then I have Rise Against Cancer, which Zeke is... the love interest in my Rise video, and he's a good guy. He's got a great family. People wanted to beat him up and all that good stuff, but Zeke came through. He's not what the video portrays.
This is some good. I was about to eat the microphone. This is some good ass shrimp. I just had to say that. A1 hospitality. You get an A for effort. Here you go. I'm gonna eat it up.
So, can you hear me? So I just wanted to just quickly tell you my shows. So the 16th, I have Hamilton, New Jersey. Then the 23rd is going to be Miami, which is going to be Miramar. And the 24th is going to be the Rise Against Cancer on the Beach. It's all about a benefit and supporting the Rise Against Cancer movement. I'm always up to support whatever I can. You know, I wrote the record to inspire people, and I go by that rule. So that's where I'm at with that. They're not listening to me over there. I also have Resorts Casino on the 15th. It's been moved around like 3 times. So I have to call my choreographer to make sure that her dancers can make it, which is Queens 360. I'm also going to do Calandra's May 30th. Andy Panda's going to be there. That's a great throwback. So just check it out. I'm going to post the fly, my itinerary. It keeps changing, as you can see. So that's why I don't want to post, because some dates come in and then they get switched around. So thank you guys for following me and still being on. I don't know what you're doing tonight. I know we went on overtime. You can always catch this video tomorrow. But I do want to use Eddie B for some DJing whatever he's going to do on stage with me is going to be spontaneous. It's not going to be scripted. And we're going to, I'm going to get it together a little bit. Right now I'm all over because I'm very excited. I want to give shout outs to Jimmy Sounds. He's crucial with, you know, our team. So I need for you to know that, Jim. And life goes on. We're gonna do our thing. Come over here. Come here. So, come on. We'll share the mic. Let's share this. So he's been he's very instrumental in all my merchandise and all my support. He's been a big part of it. So big shout out to you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very
yes.
much. Appreciate that so much.
Yeah, it goes a long way. Listen. All the DJs are, I give them props, but I can't give props to everyone individually. But thank you, because of the DJs, I wouldn't be here. You got to play my music. I taught this guy. Yeah.
A shameless plug. I just want to let y'all know right now, my mixtape is out right now. You can find it on the page. That's going to post it later, because two of those mixes I did are on that. Just want to let y'all know right now. Hold on. I'm Fatboy Fresh, so I got to get my stomach in there as well. But let y'all know the mixtape's out there. The Zen Melendez is all over it. I'm a DJ. That's the manager. This is Jim Sounds. And yeah, that's it.
Pero ¿dónde tú encontraste ese vaino?
All right, but real quick, because we're almost done and we keep taking Lissette's mic away. But Jim, come over here. Not only is he marketing, not only is he promotion, not only is he putting tables, like literally we were late because Jimmy got stuck in traffic, drove 2 hours, put the equipment together, put the cameras, all that together within 15, 20 minutes. That's the skills that you possess. But not only that, you're a hell of a fucking DJ. And I'm going to say it right now, and I'm going to put the stamp on. You know what I'm saying? Hell of a fucking DJ. And recognize what he does and what he brings to the table for this genre. And that's why when you build a team, you build it right. And you start with marketing, you start with DJing, you start with, you know, promotion, you start with the artistry, you start with the management, and then you start with building the brand. So we're going to sign off tonight, and I just want to say thank you for watching us. I know we talked a lot, but I think you needed to know what Lissette is doing, 2019, 2020, her brand, and what she's going to do for the genre. So just look out for that, and let's just continue taking this music to another level, because all the artists in this genre, they work hard, they struggle, they bust their ass day in and day out. Your favorite freestyle fans are out there every day busting their ass on their merchandise, doing for you, and you are showing them love back, and we just want to say thank you. All right, so Jim, we're going to sign off. Lissette, we're going to sign off. Just say goodbye. Say goodbye to your people. We're going to walk away and just give you some time with this lovely lady.
All right. I'm humbly saying that. It's all shits and giggles. I'm not offending nothing. Listen, one thing I do, I joke around a lot. And sometimes my humor is a little dark and people don't get it. And I don't mean to offend anybody. So if you don't have a light heart and you're going to take things too serious, I think we're living in a world that's way too serious. And that's not the world I want to live in. So with that being said, I want to thank my team. It's going to be awesome. 2019 is going to be crazy. And just stay tuned. This is my remix. I worked really hard on Rise. And I don't know how I got these girls to do drop verses into the remix. But they did. And eventually, we'll be able to perform it together. And if not, you know what? It's recorded, and I have history. Compromise. I wish Judy was here, but I'm going to do a verse. I'm going to sing it anyway, all right? Here we go. I'm standing my ground. There's no way that I'll allow. You'll never hurt me again, cause I will fight to the end. It's been a long time coming, a long time coming now. Walk on now, cause love don't live here anymore. I refuse to fall, cause I will rise above it all now. Rise! So guys, thank you all for tuning in, and I gotta leave. I don't want to bore you to death. I'm sorry to say, yeah, enough. I don't know how to say well is enough.